Now, I'm going to talk to you about safety attitude today. Now, let me explain to you what I mean by safety attitude. To me, safety is an attitude. Occupational health and safety happens to be a compliance mechanism of rules and processes and procedures. But the choice to whether or not, without having to be policed, you choosing safety means you possess a safety attitude. Now, safety attitude can be equated in the same way to a leadership attitude, where leadership is an attitude, but management is a position. And in the same way that service is an attitude, but customer service is a department. Do you follow what I'm saying? Safety is an attitude. It is an on-off switch. It's either on or it's off. And it's not sort of on for a few hours of the day and then it's off. It's either on or off. It's the same idea as people who wear the requisite PPE, put on the hard hats and the safety goggles and the gloves on their hands and the hearing protection, and they've got the steel-toed boots on and they work safely from 8 to 4 during the day and then go home and cut the lawn in their flip-flops. Don't even think about laughing, you do it. Now, the only thing that you're going to need to remember here today as we go through the 10 safety attitude strategies is these three words that I'm about to give you. Now, if you embrace these three words, when you leave here today, get back to work tomorrow, it'll begin to change the way you look at the job function, communication with your coworkers, communication interdepartmentally, and how you look at safety in your workplace every single day. Embracing three words. If you embrace these three words, by the way, when you get home tonight, it might begin to change the way you handle your own relationships and possibly even parenting issues. Three very important words that you're going to need to remember. And I see a few of you getting ready to write this down. It is three words, people. It's not that hard. But if you need to write it down, you fill your boots. All right? Here come the three words, and they are trust the process. I know some of you are looking at me like, we're a municipal government. You want us to trust what? Trust the process. Can you repeat that for me? Holy smokes, that is really poopy, gotta tell you. You know, as a former mascot, there's a certain level of enthusiasm I'm expecting here, just not seeing it right now. So let's try that again with enthusiasm. One, two, three.
Trust the process.
Now, what does that mean? It means that every decision you've ever made in your whole life, every event, every experience of your whole life has put you in this room here today. Now, some of you should be very afraid. Oh, seriously. You know, from the decision you made years ago to pick up your toys because you didn't like the way the neighbor kid played, to the decision you made to be here today, every decision, event, and experience of your whole life has put you in this room here today. Now, the truth is, each of us in this room is the sum total of every decision, event, and experience of our whole lives. Everything that's ever happened to us in the past has turned us into exactly the person that we are today. Based on the experiences that we've had, the results from the decisions we've made, it kind of jades how we view life. And you know, nothing is more prevalent in your decision-making ability than how each of us embraces the idea of safety. This is part of what I'm going to talk to you about here today, the 10 strategies on safety attitude. The only thing that you're going to need to remember is trust the process. There is a process we're going to go through here this morning. We ready to go? All right, strategy number one, safety attitude. You are responsible for your own
safety.
You would think that, wouldn't you? And you would probably not be wrong, but that's not the point that I'm trying to make. I want to go further than safety. You are responsible for your own happiness. And safety comes along with that. And in fact, we don't buy into that whole idea that we're responsible for our own happiness, and I'll prove it to you. I want everyone in the room to just cross their arms if they would. Now, when you got your arms crossed, I want you to look at the person sitting next to you and make sure they're doing it right. Hey, we want to be right, right? Now, I want you to uncross your arms and cross them the other way. That's the toughest thing you're going to do today. That's hard, isn't it? Who thinks it feels a little weird, a little unnatural, a little uncomfortable? On a show of hands, congratulations, it's supposed to. Now, here's why. Years ago, Mark Twain said the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over day in, day out, the exact same way, and expecting a different result every time. And yet, we're all guilty of this. Do you know that each single person in this room has between 60 and 70,000 thoughts every single day. Now, some of you are looking at the guy next to you going, there's no way he has that many. It's an average. But it's 60 to 70,000 thoughts every single day. And you know what? We make decisions on every one of those thoughts. Exactly the same way we cross our arms. We don't even think about it anymore. And I'll prove it to you. You probably get up at exactly the same time every single morning, walk into the bathroom, brush your teeth the exact same way. Okay, for some of us, just a matter of taking them out of the glass and the nightstand, but we do it the same way. And if you have breakfast, you have the same breakfast you do every single morning. You drive the same route to work, you have to work at the same time, see the same people, do the same things, take the same breaks during the day. Of course, go home at the end of the day. At the end of the day, it's Tuesday, so it's fish sticks night on Tuesday. We always have fish sticks on Tuesday. We go watch the same TV shows we watch every Tuesday night. We go to bed at the exact same time, lie in that exact same bed, looking at the ceiling, saying, why can't my life be different? Well, here's a clue. You need to do something different. But we don't get that. And the reason that is because a long time ago, we bought into a philosophy that said, when I find the perfect job, then I'll be happy. No, I find the perfect relationship. Oh, then I'll be happy. Who's still looking? You're going to keep looking until you figure this out. I'll help you though. We convince ourselves, no, it's when I have a lot of money, then I will be happy. No, when I finally retire, oh good, yes, then I'll be happy. Well, here's a clue. If you're 65 and not happy, you're not starting now. No, you're going to be the same miserable person you always were, just no job to go to. Because here's what I figured out about happiness. It is not a result. It's a choice. It's the same choice you made to be here. It's the same choice you make to hold the door open for somebody. It's the same choice you're running down to the Starbucks or running out for a coffee. You ask anybody else in the office if they want a coffee. That's a choice. Being here today was a choice. Don't kid yourself, it was. There's always a choice. Everything has a choice. And that includes being happy. The choice of whether or not you choose to embrace safety, well, that's your call. Safety is not a result. It's a choice. The record of that safety is the result. You are responsible for your own happiness in the same way that you are responsible for your own safety. It's a choice that you get to make. If you get it, those three words I asked you to remember are? Oh, maybe you should have wrote it down then, huh? Try it again. One, two, three. Okay.